Well, 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 today we have one of my longest videos, if not the longest video I've posted on the channel. We're going to be talking about One Piece Egghead Arc, everything that has happened so far from the start to where we are currently. This arc is shaping up to be one of, if not the best One Piece arc we've seen so far, and even stretching it even farther to being one of the best anime arcs in general. So without further ado, let's get right to it. Following their escape from Wano, the Straw Hats, now on their ship, digest the events that unfold while they were away. Nami, in a disciplinary act, confines Luffy to a cage. The crew, upon reading the latest newspaper, learns about the increase in their bounties and other significant global happenings. They are particularly shocked by the news of King Cobra's death and Princess Vivi's mysterious disappearance. Zoro counsels Luffy against immediately rushing to Vivi's aid, suggesting that they wait until it's clear she's in danger. The topic then shifts to Sabo, with Luffy unable to believe that Sabo could be responsible for Cobra's death. This disbelief stems from a deeply personal memory of Luffy sharing his dream with Sabo and Ace, a moment that resonated strongly with the crew. The conversation lightens when Sanji jokes about Luffy's mental state, leading to a brief exchange about the feasibility of Luffy's dream of becoming the Pirate King. Franky, always supportive, emphasizes the need to locate the elusive Last Road Poneglyph to achieve their grand aspiration. Robin, however, notes the difficulty of this task given the Poneglyph's mysterious location. Elsewhere, the story touches on Marco's departure from the Straw Hats at Sphinx Island, reminiscing about their shared experiences and the growth they've all undergrone since the Summit War of Marine Ford. Yamato reveals his decision to stay back in Wano for its protection against a potential threats like Ryokugyu. Meanwhile, on Karibari Island, Buggy faces an interrogation from Crocodile and Mihawk about his false claim of leading the Cross Guild. When Crocodile learns of the Marines' attack on Buggy, he proposes an alliance. However, this actual motive is to collect a debt from Buggy. This misunderstanding leads to Buggy being mistakenly identified as the leader of the Cross Guild and one of the Four Emperors, significantly raising his, Crocodile's, and Mihawk's bounties. Mihawk expresses indifference to being an emperor, seeing Buggy as a suitable figurehead for their group. The scene shifts to Amazon Lily, where Gloriosa comments on the unprecedented scale of the island's invasion. Boa Hancock amidst threats from the Marines expresses her desire to marry Luffy, much to Gloriosa's annoyance. The attack on Amazon Lily escalates with the introduction of the new pacifista, Seraphim. The Blackbeard pirates arrive, aiming to seize Hancock's Meromero no Mi power, leading to a fierce battle. Hancock's ability turns her enemies to stone, but the tide turns when Blackbeard captures her. However, just as Blackbeard is about to execute Hancock, Rayleigh arrives and convinces him to leave the island. Rayleigh and Shaki, the former empress of the Kuja pirates, remain on the island, reflecting on the events. A marine ship reports heading to Egghead Island, with Kobe now a hostage of the Blackbeard pirates. At the Kamabaka Kingdom, the Revolutionary Army officers express relief over Sabo's survival. However, Dragon is deeply concerned about Sabo's alleged involvement in Cobra's murder. A phone call from Sabo to the revolutionaries get intercepted by the Marines, who trace it to Lelouchia Kingdom, revealing the country's rebellion during the Eight Nation Revolution. Sabo, during the call, denies murdering Cobra and instead speaks of witnessing something horrific. As he speaks, a cloud-covered object appears in the sky above Lelouchia, from which Emu launches a devastating laser attack, annihilating the kingdom and declaring that it never existed. This attack reveals the previously hidden occupant of the empty throne, adding a layer of mystery and intrigue to the unfolding events. After their departure from Wano, the Straw Hats, while sailing towards their next destination, enter a frigid zone of the sea. In this icy environment, they encounter a warm eddy, a swirling ocean current, where they find Jewelry Bonnie, who has been transformed into a toddler. Zoro takes swift action, slicing through the eddy to free her. In the midst of this, a massive mechanical shark known as Mecha Shark launches an unexpected attack on their ship, the Thousand Sunny. As the Sunny faces imminent danger, Franky tries to maneuver the ship to safety. The situation becomes more perilous when Luffy, Bonnie, and Chopper fall overboard. Jinbei, the skilled fisherman of the crew, dives into the treacherous waters to rescue them. However, their troubles are far from over as the Mecha Shark fires homing torpedoes, leading to the capsizing of the Sunny. Jinbei does his best to protect the Devil Fruit users, evading further cannon attacks from the Mecha Shark. Simultaneously, at Marine Base G14, there's a sense of urgency among the officers. Helmeppo, along with the others, pleads with Tashigi and Rear Admiral Prince Grooves for permission to embark on a rescue mission to save Kobe, who is in peril at Hachinosu. The request, however, is denied due to the inability to contact ex-Drake and send a Seraphim from Egghead, leaving them in a state of helplessness. Meanwhile, Jinbei leads Luffy, Chopper, and Bonnie to the nearby Egghead Island for refuge. Egghead Island is no ordinary place. It is said to be a technologically advanced island that is allegedly 500 years ahead of its time, housing the research facilities of the mysterious Dr. Vegapunk. Bonnie reveals her purpose for traveling alone to this futuristic island. She has unfinished business with Vegapunk. Upon their arrival, the group is astounded by the sights of enormous robots, aliens, and even food. However, they soon discover that many of these marvels are mere holograms, an impressive display of the island's advanced technology. In a surprising turn of events, a large robotic girl, initially believed to be another hologram, turns out to be real. After an interaction where Luffy punches her, thinking she's an illusion and gets punched back, she introduces herself as Dr. Vegapunk. This revelation is met with skepticism from Bonnie, who insists she knows the real Vegapunk. The plot thickens when a woman emerges from the mecha that had engaged the mecha shark. She rescues the Sunny and reveals herself to be another iteration of Dr. Vegapunk, specifically Punk number 2, Lilith, and not the original Stella. The Straw Hats find themselves in a tense situation as they are surrounded by massive sea beast weapons. Lilith demands they surrender their loot, causing an uneasy standoff. However, Shaka, identified as Punk number 1, contacts Lilith and reprimands her of her actions, warning her the potential threat posed by members of the Straw Hats, particularly Zoro and Robin. The Straw Hats then embark on an exploration of Egghead Island's labo phase. They are fascinated by the high-tech environment, including a phase-through entrance, an escalator showcasing the island's advanced engineering. The crew changes into new attire, using a Tranko's clothes dispenser, but their failure to pay for the goods and services triggers an attack from a pacifista police officer. An emotional moment arises when Bonnie stops Luffy from fighting back and reveals that Kuma, the former ruler of Sorbet Kingdom and a member of the Revolutionary Army, is her father. This revelation casts doubt on the widely accepted story of Kuma's past and his voluntary transformation into a cyborg for Vegapunk's experiments. Elsewhere, aboard a world government ship, agents Rob Lucci, Kaku, and Stussy discuss their latest assignments, the assassination of Dr. Vegapunk. The plot reveals that Vegapunk, overwhelmed with work, has split his consciousness among several entities, known as satellites. The CP0 agents are tasked with eliminating all incarnations of Vegapunk while minimizing damage to the lab, and they are also to deliver S-Bear. Lucci expresses curiosity about the connection of their mission to the events of Lelouchia, but is cautioned against probing too deeply. While all of this is occurring, the Heart Pirates face a daunting challenge in the waters around Winter Island. They are ambushed by the Blackbeard Pirates, leading to an intense confrontation. During the skirmish, Law's crew undergoes a transformation into woman, a result of Doc Q's Shiku Shiku no Mi ability. The battle intensifies with strategic moves and displays of devil fruit powers. Back on Egghead Island, the Straw Hats continue to unravel the mysteries of the island and its connection to the ancient past. They learn about the island's origins, its link to the Void Century, and the conflict between the Great Kingdom and the 20 countries that form the world government. The crew is stunned by these revelations, particularly the implication that if the world government learns of their knowledge, they could become targets for erasure. Shaka shares his insights about the Void Century and the destruction of Ohara, suggesting that the will of Ohara persists. The story then delves into Vegapunk's past interactions with Professor Clover of Ohara, revealing Vegapunk's respect for the island's intellectual legacy. After the Ohara incident, Vegapunk discovers a lake filled with books, the last remnants of Ohara knowledge. This discovery enables the preservation of Ohara's history and wisdom. Robin, emotionally touched by this revelation, inquires about the fate of these books and confirms Vegapunk's theory about Ohara's discoveries. Shaka recounts how giants from Elbaf, led by a bandaged giant, helped dredge the books from the lake. Dragon's presence at the site and his interactions with Vegapunk are also detailed, highlighting Dragon's early motivations for opposing the world government and the foundings of the Revolutionary Army. The story shifts back to the Straw Hat's encounter with Vegapunk, who is partially integrated with the Iron Giant. Vegapunk shares his aspirations to create free, limitless energy for humanity and reveals his consumption of the Nomi Nomi Nomi, a devil fruit that granted him infinite knowledge capacity but required his constant brain expansion. To manage this, he transformed his brain into Punk Records, an enormous egg-like structure housing the labo phase. Vegapunk explains his distribution of labor among the satellites, each representing a different facet of his personality, contributing to a collective pool of knowledge and ideas. The tension escalates when Bonnie, enraged by Vegapunk's role in her father's transformation, confronts him with the beam saber. Vegapunk, however, warns her of the saber's flaw. It attracts insects, leading to Bonnie's fainting from fear as a swarm approaches. Vegapunk expresses remorse over his actions and discusses the artificial devil fruit created from Momonosuke, deeming it a failure despite its functional similarities to Kaido's abilities. The story then takes a turn as the Straw Hats watch Vegapunk talk with Luffy in the labo phase monitor room. The topic of the Iron Giant arises, with Shaka revealing his inability to replicate his dynamic power source. The situation on Egghead Island becomes more dire as CP0 breaches the sea beast weapon defense line. In response, Shaka prepares for war instructing the agents to withdraw the Seraphim and leave immediately. The story then shifts to Memorial Island, where the revolutionaries are in disarray as Kuma, undergoing repairs, suddenly starts running towards the coast. Kuma's desperate escape, powered by his Niku Niku no Mi ability, leaves the revolutionaries in shock. Back on Egghead, Vegapunk explains to Luffy his vision of transforming energy into a tangible, harnessable form, aiming to resolve the primary cause of conflict, the scarcity of resources for energy production. He reveals his discovery of ancient energy, the power source of the Iron Giant. However, their conversation is abruptly cut short by an explosion, signaling CP0's landing on the island. Vegapunk deduces that the world government seeks to eliminate him due to his excessive curiosity about the Void Century. He urgently requests the Straw Hats to take him off the island, which Luffy agrees to, amused by Vegapunk's comical head. In the labo phase on Egghead, Pythagoras tries to diplomatically request CP0 agents to let S-Bear return independently and for the other agents to retreat. Lucci, suspecting Vegapunk of foul play, brings up the Egghead disappearances involving missing government ships from CP5, CP7, and CP8. Pythagoras insists the ships left safely, but Lilith, infuriated by the insinuation, considers allowing the agents in to prove their innocence. Ultimately, the satellites decide to cut off communication and ask the agents to leave. Unbeknownst to the Vegapunks, Pythagoras reports the agents' presence in the Fabrio phase, with sea beast weapons attacking their ship. Shaka realizes the agents are set on confrontation and starts evacuating personnel, calling back Atlas and mobilizing Seraphim under Sentomaru's command. The CP0 agents counter the sea beast weapons as they approach Egghead. They discuss potentially executing Jewelry Bonnie, reported to be heading to Egghead. Pythagoras contacts them again, reiterating his request for them to leave. Lucci decides to surrender the ship to the sea beast and use S-Bear's powers to transport them to the island. Upon arrival in the Fabrio phase, Kaku mistakenly attacks a holographic space monster. Stussy belatedly informs him it's a hologram, causing frustration. Kaku then tries entering the labo phase, using Geppo, inadvertently triggering laser fire from crossing the frontier dome, resulting in them crash landing. Atlas confronts the agents, but Lucci quickly incapacitates her. The CP0 agents find themselves facing Jinbei, Chopper, Luffy, and the unconscious Bonnie. Luffy and Lucci recognize each other, but Kaku cautions against engaging, given Luffy's status as an emperor. Nevertheless, a skirmish breaks out. At Marine HQ, Akainu learns of the Straw Hat's presence on Egghead and surmises Vegapunk hired them. He orders CP0 to await Marine reinforcement, with Kizaru already en route on another mission. Garp at Marine Base G14 decides to head to Hachinosu to rescue Kobe from Blackbeard, inviting Helmeppo to join him. Meanwhile, Kuma reaches the Red Line and attempts to scale it, facing fierce resistance and mortar fire from the Marines. Elsewhere, the Kid Pirates spot Elbaf. In Egghead's monitor room, Vegapunk appears during Luffy and Lucci's fight. He muses on the nature of Devil Fruits, comparing Gear 5 to the Sun God Nika, and theorizing that they represent human evolutions and desire. Sentomaru, learning of the assassination plot against Vegapunk, feels betrayed and joins the battle against CP0. Frankie gets emotional, seeing the Seraphim, particularly S-Shark, who possesses abilities similar to Senior Pink. Both Luffy and Lucci engage in their awakened forms in combat. Sentomaru arrives with additional Seraphim, and a struggle for command over the cyborgs ensues. Lucci injures Sentomaru, but Luffy intervenes, launching Lucci away with a powerful attack. The Seraphim display their Devil Fruit powers against CP0, with Luffy blocking Lucci's path during another confrontation. Luffy promises Sentomaru to evacuate Vegapunk from Egghead. However, Luffy rapidly ages after deactivating his awakening, and Bonnie regains consciousness, confused. Upon arrival at the labo phase, Bonnie angrily sees Vegapunk, blaming him for her father's state. The Straw Hats in the monitor room ponder why the government wants Vegapunk dead, and his rationale for aiding them. Stussy, revealed as Vegapunk's ally and a clone of the Rock's pirate Buckingham Stussy, subdues Lucci and Kaku, leaving the Seraphim under CP0's command. Zoro and Brook fend off an attack on the Thousand Sunny, and the satellites intervene, ordering the Seraphim to combat CP0. Nami and Usopp remain with Shaka, who becomes alarmed as CP0 orders the Seraphim to destroy the lab. Bonnie confronts Vegapunk, demanding answers about her father, Kuma. Vegapunk refuses to disclose the truth, citing a promise to Kuma. Bonnie discovers a memory bubble and experiences a glimpse of Kuma's painful past, leading her to faint. Luffy, reuniting with his crew, promises to evacuate Vegapunk. However, Bonnie goes missing in the chaos. Shaka observes the situation, realizing the Seraphim followed CP0 on their own. The Straw Hats and satellites strategize, with Frankie and Sanji joining Zoro and Brook to defend the lab. Lilith and Edison successfully command the Seraphim to halt their attack, ending the threat to the lab. Meanwhile, Marco learns of a marine attack on Sphinx targeting Whitebeard's treasure. Miss Buckin reveals as Buckingham Stussy and Weevil's mother, implores Marco to save Weevil and find the treasure. Kizaru, en route to Egghead with the fleet, is informed of his new mission to support the operation against Vegapunk. Back on Egghead Island, Sentomaru regains consciousness and takes control, commanding a pacifista Mark III to detain the remaining Cypherpole agents in the Fabrio phase. He also orders 50 pacifista Mark IIIs to assist in facilitating the Straw Hat's escape with Vegapunk, though he's unable to establish contact with Vegapunk or receive outside update. Meanwhile, Luffy, unable to locate Vegapunk or Bonnie, joins Zoro, Brook, and Stussy, regrouping with the others in the Lavo phase. Monitoring the situation, Shaka notices Bonnie but fails to spot Vegapunk. Pythagoras is already on the hunt for Vegapunk, and Nami suggests the crew join the search, unable to depart without him. Zoro and Luffy remain behind, tending to the unconscious Kaku and Lucci. During the search, an explosion rocks a lab section, alarming Pythagoras. Elsewhere, Morgans, aboard his news balloon, learns that Luffy is on Egghead and that the world government seeks Vegapunk's elimination. Preparing to publish a story depicting Luffy as Vegapunk's captor, Morgans is corrected by Nefertari Vivi, argues that he's misrepresenting Luffy. Wapo, fearing the world government eavesdropping, urges Vivi to stay silent, but Morgans dismisses her concerns, prioritizing a lucrative story. Back in the lab, Shaka, observing through Dendenmushi, witnesses Pythagoras being attacked and the feed abruptly cut. Luffy also notices a disruption in radio communication. Shaka realizes that surveillance cameras across Egghead are being dismantled. Teams from the Straw Hat and Stella units are dispatched to search for Vegapunk. Nami, Brook, and Edison, investigating Building A's third level, find a jewelry-producing machine, intriguing Nami despite being urged to focus on the search. In Building A's second floor, Chopper, Robin, and Atlas discover a section dedicated to artificial organ production. Sanji, Stussy, and Jinbei explore Building B's development floor, while Usopp, Lilith, York, and Franky head to Building C. Upon reaching the site of Pythagoras' attack, they find his body, which had ejected from its larger form before the explosion. Near S-Snake, Pythagoras warns York to stay awake, but S-Snake, using Hancock's Miramaru no Mi abilities, turns York to stone and attacks the group. Communication breakdowns lead to confusion among Lilith and Edison, who are unable to access the main control room despite their high clearance. Meanwhile, Shaka and Luffy are perplexed as S-Bear and S-Hawk launch an unexpected attack on the lab in Building A. Shaka sees Zoro fighting to protect the defenses Lucci and Kaku, realizing that someone is commanding the Seraphim to eliminate everyone inside. Despite Lucci's request for assistance, Luffy and Zoro refuse to release him and Kaku. The relentless Seraphim force Luffy and Zoro to protect Lucci and Kaku, with Zoro recognizing S-Hawk's use of Mr. One's Super No Mi power. Lucci reveals their mission is to assassinate Vegapunk and the satellites, including Stussy, for her betrayal. Faced with no other choice, Luffy agrees to release them under the condition that they target their assigned victims only after defeating him. Lucci agrees, intending to kill Luffy before his crew. In a sinister development, agents from CP5, 7, and 8 are found in prison in the basement of the former Devil Fruit Research Center, having been held captive for 2 months with minimal food. Vegapunk's awakening to this reality confirms Lucci's allegations of agents vanishing near the island. One captive reveals that they were pursued by sea beast weapons and taken prisoner. On Elbaf, a young giant pleads with Shanks to take him along, but Rockstar interrupts, informing Shanks of an attack near the island. Shanks regrets his displayed departure, but refuses to let Elbaf become a battleground. Joining forces with Dory and Brogy, they confront the Kid Pirates. Shanks challenges Yusa's Kid, recalling their past encounter that cost Kid his arm, and Kid resolves to continue the fight. Sentomaru, back on Egghead, likens the island's fate to Ohara's and hopes the Straw Hats can help Vegapunk escape. In the midst of battle, Luffy, Zoro, Lucci, and Kaku struggle against S-Hawk and S-Bear, who resemble King. Shaka speculates about the Lunarian origins and exists to search for Vegapunk. In Building A, Nami and Zeus engage S-Shark, but find their attacks ineffective. Sanji arrives to counter S-Shark's ambush. In Building C, Lilith uses her bubble cannon against S-Snake, highlighting their sea stone-like vulnerability. Franky temporarily incapacitates S-Snake, but her manipulative tactics turn the tide. Shaka discovers Vegapunk and Cypherpole agents imprisoned in the Devil Fruit Research Facility's basement. As he prepares to free them, an unexpected assailant shoots Shaka. Stussy and Jinbei continue their search in Building B, while Sentomaru learns of a world government plan to destroy Egghead, with CP0 leading the charge, followed by a marine fleet. Sentomaru orders the island's evacuation, anticipating a buster call. In Building C, S-Snake, unopposed due to Franky's partial petrification, focuses her attack on him. Meanwhile, Atlas, recognizing a commotion in Building A, leads Robin and Chopper to investigate. Sanji assumes command in the battle against S-Shark, showcasing his new Germa upgrades. The Seraphim, realizing they can't harm Luffy's group by extinguishing their flames, shift tactics. Lucci deduces S-Hawk's strategy to target weaker opponents. Luffy orders Kaki to follow Zoro while he continues battling S-Bear. Elsewhere, Bonnie remains engulfed in Kuma's memories. 3 months prior, the five elders were informed by an Egghead representative about Vegapunk's weapon research, prompting them to send Cypherpaw agents to investigate. In the present, York is identified as Shaka's shooter, confessing her desire to become a celestial dragon and be the sole surviving Vegapunk. She admits to orchestrating the Seraphim's orders to eliminate everyone but herself, Vegapunk, and the Cypherpaw hostages. York manipulates S-Snake to act out of her plan, turning herself to stone as a trick. Near Elbaf, Shanks' supporters initially confronted the Kid Pirates, but Shanks instructed them to stand down. He noticed Kid preparing to use his damn punk weapon and swiftly acted, disabling the railgun on the Victoria Punk before Kid could fire. Shanks uses a named attack, Kamusadi, also known as Divine Departure, ending the fight quickly. In the ensuing clash, both Kid and Killer were incapacitated, and the surviving Kid Pirates, overwhelmed by Shanks' Conqueror's Haki, surrendered their rogue Poneglyph to save themselves. Shanks accepted these and left as Dory and Brogy's Hakoku attack split the Kid Pirate's ship in two, sinking it. On Hachinosu, Kobe, aided by Perona, escaped captivity, releasing Gecko Moria as a part of their agreement. The island pirates, eyeing the Cross Guild bounty, pursued him. During his escape, Kobe freed several imprisoned marines. Meanwhile, Blackbeard's commanders Shiru, Avalo Pizarro, and Vasco Shot, armed with the Shima Shima no Mi and Gabu Gabu no Mi, debated capturing Kobe. A flashback revealed Blackbeard's plan to use Kobe to gain recognition from the world government as the ruler of Hachinosu. Kobe revealed his affiliation with Sword, a rogue marine faction, implying the marines would not back their actions. Despite this, Blackbeard kept Kobe captive, hoping his notoriety would sway the world government. During Kobe's ongoing escape, a marine infiltration on the island was discovered, leading to confrontation with Kujaku, Suru's granddaughter. Kujaku used her Muchi Muchi no Mi powers to trap the pirates, and Hibari, using GP flowers, turned their bullets into flowers, signaling to Prince Groose that Kobe was safe. Garp, preparing to act, was briefed by Tashigi and Helmeppo. They launched an attack on the pirate gathering using a technique similar to Franky's coup de burst. As Garp laminated his overwhelming strength, Groose used his clay powers to cushion the ship's landing. Surprisingly, Kuzan arrived and froze Hibari, prompting Garp to question his intentions. In a flashback, Kuzan's post-marine life included an encounter with Blackbeard's crew and a conversation with Blackbeard himself. The discussion hinted at a mysterious man with the rogue Poneglyph and Kuzan's potential alliance with Blackbeard's crew. In the present, Kuzan, now aligned with Blackbeard, confronts Garp. Following their victory over the Heart Pirates, the Blackbeard Pirates faced Trafalgar Law. Blackbeard pondered over the fate of the Ape Ape no Mi, while Beppo, transformed into a Sulong form, helped Law escape into the sea. Despite their weakened state, they resolved to trust the crew's survival. At New Marine Ford, Sengoku and Suru reacted to the news about T-Bone's death and expressed concern over increasing betrayals within the Marines. They were shocked to learn of Garp and Kujaku's unauthorized mission to Hachinosu. On Karibari Island, Buggy reassured a remorseful man who killed T-Bone, promising safety and financial support through the bounty. The unveiling of the Cross Guild flagship, modeled after Buggy, displeased Crocodile and Mihawk, who took out their frustration on him. Buggy reminisced about his past with Shanks, reflecting on the divergent paths and his decision to chase the One Piece, much to Mihawk and Crocodile's dismay. On Memorial Island, several revolutionaries spot a ship approaching, revealing Sabo aboard with recruits who were calling for help before Imu's attack on Lelouchia Kingdom. Though he sent a coded message confirming his safety, Sabo refrained from further communication due to possible marine interception. Meeting Ivankov and Dragon, Sabo recounts his achievements at Marie Joie, including destroying food supplies, saving Kuma, and declaring war on the world nobles. They sorrow Cobra's death and discuss the threat of the God's Knights from the world government targeting Sabo. At Marie Joie, Sabo and Bonnie team up to save Kuma and release slaves, keeping Admirals Fujitora and Ryukyu occupied. Cobra entrusts Vivi's safety to CP0 and confronts the world nobles about their non-intervention in saving Shirahoshi. Meanwhile, Sabo retrieves slave collar keys and overhears a discussion about a mysterious vanishing room, parting ways with Bonnie, who heads to Egghead, while Sabo goes to Kamabaka. Cobra, speaking with the five elders, questions the origins of the Celestial Dragons and the disappearance of Nefertari Lily from Arabasta's records post-Void Century. He probes about the D initial, a mystery stretching back 800 years. Meanwhile, St. Charlos attempts to abduct Shirahoshi with Kuma's aid, but is thwarted by Sai, Leo, and Don Quixote in Jozar. The situation escalates as Imu, one of the original 20 monarchs, appears in the empty throne room, revealing the D-bearers are adversaries of the world government. Cobra learns that the Poneglyph's dispersion was Lily's mistake, leading to the pirate era. As Cobra reveals Lily's full name, Nefertari D. Lily, Imu kills him. Sabu attempts to rescue Cobra, but is overwhelmed by Imu's power and the witness of Cobra's death. This is where we get to see hidden figures of not only Imu, but the other five elders. Wapo witnesses the incident and flees, leading to speculation about Cobra's stance on the warlord system, abolition. Vivi is captured by CP0, fearing her fate as a world noble's pet, but finds solace knowing Shirahoshi is safe. As this concludes, the Arabasta delegation searches for their missing king and princess. Sabo and Bonnie secure independent escapes, with Sabo later learning about Cobra's death and his own framing. The Elder Stars, now known as Saints, discuss dealing with Sabo as Imu orders the use of the Mother Flame on Lelouch Kingdom and Vivi's recapture. The Marines deploy Seraphims to quell the resulting rebellions. Sabo, hailed as a hero in Lelouchia, struggles with the truth of Cobra's death. Dragon and Ivankov speculate on Imu's identity and the weapon's origins, suspecting either an ancient weapon or a Vegapunk creation. Emery Joie, M'Jozard faces execution for defending the Neptune family, underscoring the harsh realities within the world government. At the G1 naval base, Bernou introduces Full Body and Django to the battleship Bag, a training ship used by Garp and Kuzan to strengthen their punching power without devil fruit or haki powers. Meanwhile, on Hachinosu, Garp's formidable strength is showcased as he easily overpowers Sanjun Wolf. Amidst the chaos, Vasco Shot attempts to attack Garp using two pirates as a shield, but Garp's reputation deters the pirates, knowing Blackbeard would retaliate if Garp were harmed. Kujaku announces all prisoners are ready for departure, prompting Garp to order a retreat, acknowledging the overwhelming pirate numbers. Kuzan confronts Garp about letting the prisoners go, but the conversation is cut short as Shiru, using his invisibility, ambushes Garp, inflicting a serious stomach wound. Despite this, Garp retaliates fiercely, but the damage is done. Amidst the battle, Kuzan reflects on his past with Garp, recalling their training days and Garp's mentorship, which saw Kuzan rise to admiral rank. Kuzan reminisces about their shared snacks and Garp's familial struggles with Dragon and Luffy. The scene shifts to Kobe's training days, where Garp, as a guest lecturer, challenging cadets with moral dilemmas, recognizing their potential despite unconventional solutions. In Amazon Lily, Vice Admiral Yamakaji contemplates sacrificing Marines to avoid conflict with Blackbeard, but Kobe intervenes, offering himself for the officer's safety. Back in the present, as Pizarro's Island hand threatens to the Marine ship, the Marines prepare for evacuation. Kobe, with Garp's strategic guidance, leads a daring plan involving Himepo, Gris, and himself to counterattack. Despite being wounded, Garp's actions inspire Kobe, who manages to destroy Pizarro's hand with his honesty impact, saving the ship and impressing all. Garp reflects on Kobe's dedication during the training, leading to Kobe's current display of strength, as Garp is surrounded by pirates, including Blackbeard's officers. Kuzan freezes him, echoing his action against Saul. The next day's news headline reveals Kobe's safe return, Garp's disappearance of Hachinosu, and an incident on Egghead involving Monkey D. Luffy, now one of the Emperors of the Sea, as Borsellino's fleet approaches the island. In Fusha Village, upon hearing of Garp's capture, Mayor Whoop Slap remains confident in Garp's well-being. Makino's son is drawn to a photo of Luffy. In the mountains, Darden expresses concern for both Garp and Luffy. 6 days after Lelouch's destruction, a massive earthquake is felt across the ocean, leading to a marine ship discovering a sea-engulfing hole. This incident, unknown to all except Imu, causes rising tides and the sinking of several islands, prompting widespread panic and evacuation. On Egghead Island, a day after Kizaru's fleet arrives, 9 vice admirals await outside. Sentomaru, enraged by an attacking sea beast and forced to destroy it, unsuccessfully tries to persuade Kizaru to defy his orders, which were directly from higher ups. During this, J. Garcia Saturn instructs Doberman to keep his presence a secret and assesses the situation, including the presence of CP0, Vegapunk, Satellites, Seraphim, and Straw Hats in the lab, and the capture of the other Cypherpole agents. Concerned that those on the island may know about the Void Sentry, Saturn orders their pursuits and sinking of the ships, unconcerned about Jewelry Bonnie's threat level. A call to Elder Stars reveals Yor chastising them for attempting to kill her and the other targets, despite an agreement she had made with them. She assures them of holding the Straw Hats and CP0. In return for another Mother Flame creation, York demands Celestial Dragon status and protection for herself and the lab. Inside the labo phase, the Straw Hats, Bonnie, Vegapunk, and Lucci have York defeated, chained and surrounded. York pleads with the Elder Stars for help, but Luffy intercepts the call, informing the Elders of their allegiance to Vegapunk and warning them to call off their fleet if they care about York. Robin cuts the call short to avoid giving away too much information. Back with Saturn, he reiterates the fleet's objectives: protect York, Punk Records, and the power source. He dismisses concerns about their captured agents, considering them replaceable. Saturn then discusses with Kizaru and decides to proceed with their plans, despite Sentomaru's oversight. Inside the Labo phase, the group recuperates from their ordeal, with Chopper tending to Robin and others resting. Usopp establishes communication with the captured Cypherpole agents, who are assured of their safety by S-Snake. Franky thanks S-Snake for her earlier intervention, leading to a discussion about lineage factor. Luffy, mistaking S-Snake for Boa Hancock, asks her to free his friends, which she does out of affection for him. Vegapunk informs Luffy and Usopp of their escape route towards Elbaf, and they prepare to leave Egghead using Vega Force 1, though it can only operate within the island's airport. As the group makes their way to Vega Force 1, Kizaru intercepts them. Sentomaru bravely confronts Kizaru, recalling their past and reaffirming his commitment to protecting Vegapunk. Despite a fierce battle, Sentomaru is overpowered and Kizaru seizes control over the pacifista. The Straw Hats and Vegapunk's team continue to strategize their escape amidst the chaos, and the Marines and CP0 closing in. As the situation intensifies, Kizaru confronts the group, leading to a showdown with Luffy in Gear 5. Their battle escalates, with Kizaru acknowledging Luffy's growth but remaining resolute in his mission. Meanwhile, Saturn arrives on Egghead, transforming into a massive spider hybrid and asserting his authority, even causing a Marine's head to explode with a mere glance. Saturn's presence disrupts the escape plan, leading to a confrontation with Luffy and the group. Saturn reveals Kuma's past as a member of the extinct Buccaneer tribe and Bonnie's connection to him. In a climactic moment, Bonnie confronts Saturn about Kuma's death, and Saturn orders the Marines to target her. Bonnie, recalling Kuma's aspiration to be a hero like Nika, is filled with determination, facing her fate head on. Kuma, born 47 years ago in the Sorbet Kingdom, was a child of a human mother and a buccaneer named Clap. Due to his unique blood type being leaked, Kuma and his family were sold into slavery by the world government. Under brutal conditions as a slave, Kuma's spirit was crushed by the death of his mother and the murder of his father, who was killed for celebrating the legend of Nika, the warrior of liberation. Years later, during the native hunting competition in the West Blue, the world nobles aimed to exterminate an island's population. Young Fagarlan Garling executed the king opposing the government. At God Valley, where the competition occurred, Saturn was present and noticed Kuma's failed escaped attempt. Imperial Ivankov and Jenny intervene, saving Kuma from being punished by other slaves. During this chaotic time, Garp was called to God Valley to confront the Rock's pirates, targeting the world noble's treasure. Simultaneously, Ivankov and Kuma plan to escape using Devil Fruit awarded as competition prizes. However, Charlotte Linlin, also known as Big Mom, stole Ivankov's fruit, leading Kuma to consume his. Kuma uses newfound powers to free over 500 slaves, including Jenny and Ivankov, and they visited the Sorbet Kingdom. In Sorbet Kingdom, Kuma and Jenny read about Garp's heroics at God Valley. Kuma, now a church pastor, absorbed the congregation's pain every Sunday. Jenny, frustrated with the locals taking advantage of Kuma, proposed to him, but he refused, fearing for her safety due to his background. Around this time, Kuma learned of the Freedom Fighters, led by Dragon, and was inspired to join them. The situation in Sorbet worsened as King Bakori enslaved residents unable to pay a tribute. Kuma opposed this, leading to his arrest and labeling as a traitor. Jenny was imprisoned for protesting Kuma's arrest. Bakori then divided Sorbet Kingdom, declaring the South as a lawless region. Kuma and Jenny joined Dragon's Freedom Fighters, later known as the Revolutionary Army, fighting for oppressed people. Years later, after a failed operation, Jenny was captured and forcibly married to a world noble. She later contacted Kuma, revealing her terminal illness, Sapphire Scales, and her wish for Kuma to not search for her. Kuma found her dead, leaving with him to care for their daughter, Bonnie. He protected Bonnie, who inherited her mother's illness, and continued missions with the Revolutionary Army. Kuma's efforts in Sorbet Kingdom led to his appointment as king, but he deferred the crown to the beloved King Bulldog. Bonnie, with her devil fruit powers, changed her appearance, confusing locals about her age. Kuma then confronted Bakori at sea, defeating his fleet and earning a bounty. Later, Kuma sought Dr. Vegapunk's help for Bonnie's illness in exchange for her treatment. Kuma agreed to let Vegapunk clone him for the Marines. Despite Dragon's likely disapproval, Kuma accepted the deal to save Bonnie. Saturn and Marie Joie criticized Vegapunk for not exploiting Kuma's potential, declaring a soldier's value lies in their kill count. Saturn revealed intentions to execute his own plan. So right there, so far, is One Piece Egghead Island Arc. This is literally shaping to be one of, like I said, the best arcs we have ever seen within One Piece and even anime in general, as we have more of these chapters of Egghead is only going to enhance the just straight goldedness of this arc. I appreciate y'all tuning into the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this very long detailed explanation of One Piece Egghead arc so far. And until next time, peace out.